Out of the way. Adams has to resort to stomps, but that's not going to do any good. Gordy timed the move of Adams and got out of the way. Iceman with a stomp. Here comes Gordy again. He wants that spike. Kevin responds with the iron claw. Kevin Von Erich with the iron claw. Freebird Terry Gordy. In comes Buddy Roberts.
10 minutes gone. 10 minutes gone.
We pass the 10-minute mark in the mount. Roberts is in trouble. Kevin is running roughshod. Kevin had the iron claw and Gordy. Roberts tagged in. Now it's 3-on-1. Gordy and Parsons back into their corner. Here's Kevin with the iron claw and Roberts in the corner. Here comes Parsons, and now all of them are into it. Madness. Kevin falls between the fence and the rope. It's now 3-on-2. Roberts has Adams. Iceman on it with Simpson. Keep your eye on the Iceman and Buddy Roberts with Chris Adams. Now Gordy with a pile driver on Steve Simpson. Look out! Watch Roberts! Simpson! Or rather, Adams out of the way! Roberts. The crowd roars as Kevin waits for the right moment. Spinning body press on Roberts. 1, 2, 3. Kevin Von Erich, Chris Adams, and Steve Simpson are world tag team champions. What a thrilling event for this crowd. Let's go to Ralph Pulley.
Our congratulations to the new champions in the WCCW.
Well, PWI's Editors Award to a man who's been in wrestling for over 50 years as a wrestler, promoter, and a great humanitarian. Here is Paul Boesch to accept his award.
I want to thank the editors of Pro Wrestling Illustrated for giving me the Editors Award for 1987. It's really a big thrill. Bill Apter and Stanley Weston, whom I've known for a long time, and the fine crew, they have picked me on the premise that I've been doing over the past 55 years and saying good things about wrestling. Well, I want to tell you, I don't need an award for that. In my heart, I know what wrestling has done for me, and I've always been grateful to it for this particular award, which I never expected when I started in 1932. You know, nowadays wrestling has plenty of power, plenty of fans. Corporations run wrestling instead of individual promoters, little people, as they call us. But I want to tell you that until the corporations become thoroughly aware that the fan is a vital part of wrestling, that the fan has a heart, that the fan vibrates the whole sport, and that knowing him personally and knowing what he wants is the big thing. Wrestling fans are entertained by wrestling, and that is the fundamental answer. May I thank Pro Wrestling Illustrated Magazine. Once again, you do me a great honor.
Welcome back to Pro Wrestling This Week. Right now, Gordon, it's time for one of my favorite segments on the show, and that's Sound Off.
And with the lovely Boni Blackstone. And this week, Boni answers a question about where is Austin Idol, although I think we've seen plenty of him so far in the program. Also, some commentary on the Four Horsemen and where is Dark Journey. Boni?
Scott L. of Horton, Alabama, watching WDZX Channel 54 in Huntsville, would like to ask, where is Austin Idol, and what has he been up to since his time in Memphis, Tennessee with Tommy Rich and Paul E. Dangerously? Since Memphis, the Universal Heartthrob has been busy in the Florida and Alabama areas, but just recently he showed up in Atlanta, Georgia for a TV taping of Southern Championship Wrestling from Georgia, and believe it or not, he was there to attack Tommy Wildfire Rich when Rich refused to return to the Dangerous Alliance. Paul E. Dangerously brought Austin in to show Tommy he was making a bad mistake. Watch out for a terrible feud between these two former partners. And this comes to us from an anonymous viewer of WTTO, Channel 21 in Birmingham, Alabama. I am a Four Horsemen fanatic. I love Ric Flair and the rest of the Horsemen. I really think he's God's gift to Earth, along with Arn, James, and Tully. They are the best wrestlers in the sport today. It just scares me to think of wrestling without Flair, Blanchard, Dillon, and Anderson. What a nightmare. I haven't forgot about Lex Luger either. How could he turn on James like he did? I used to like Luger just as much as the rest of the Horsemen, but now I believe I hate him. And finally, Bobby S. from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, is watching on WDZL, Channel 39, and he wants to know the whereabouts of his favorite female manager, Dark Journey. Bobby, the beautiful Dark Journey, is on a worldwide tour looking for new wrestlers to bring back to the United States and lead to championship matches. The last word we got from her was from South America, where she claims to have found a 7-foot giant in the jungle tropics. We'll have to wait and see if she can convince this new monster to make the trip back to the United States with her. That's it for our Where Is edition of Sound Off. If you have misplaced your favorite wrestler, write to me here and let me bring you up to date. Till next time, I'm Boni Blackstone.
Thank you very much, Boni, for one of the most informative segments on pro wrestling this week. Gordon?
Wild, Wild West wrestling is next. I'll tell you what, the new spoiler faces Bobby Durell, and it's one heck of a tough match.
Is on the card tomorrow, along with the great stars Jeff Rates, Bob the Cat Bradley, Jason Sterling, another up-and-coming young man. A fine body slam. One, not quite two. Give Durell credit. He fired out of there, even though he's taking a tremendous amount of punishment. Hammering on the back of the neck, and Durell down again. We've got a big evening of excitement starting at 4 tomorrow at Billy Bob's Texan, right there what you're looking at. The new spoiler in total command so far in this bout. He has not let up. While we're talking about Wild West Wrestling, and we want you to go west, go Wild West with us. The great individuality of the great days of the old West and still evident in this great country of ours. And that permeates the entire country as Durell shows his initiative and desires. He fights out of there again. Great move by Durell. Well, that one put some hurt on the new spoiler himself as he came bounding down there. And now Durell has a chance. If he has any energy left, he dies. Trying to get his breath. Great drop kick by Durell. Look out, spoiler. Here comes Durell. Garland's finding. Bobby Durell looking for a chance now. Hasn't got time to be real. Whoa, made a bad move there, flying into the knees of the new spoiler. So the spoiler has a chance to come right back, uses that bottom rope as a choke. And Bobby Durell's moment of glory, his chance to take charge, looks like it might be gone as this new spoiler explodes on him again. Across the ring, here comes a backbreaker slammer. One, two, three. Durell is beaten by the new spoiler, who won it from an explosion.
Here is your winner, the new spoiler.
Well, the new spoiler is proving to be one tough cookie.
Absolutely, Gordon. And right now, it's time to tell everyone who won the award for the most popular wrestler of 1987. You fans have voted Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, wrestling's most popular wrestler. Now, the Midnight Express, that's Bobby Eaton and Stan Lane under the management of Jim Cornette, won the Tag Team of the Year award, while Nikita Koloff took the award for Inspirational Wrestler of the Year. Nikita has presented that plaque to the man who meant most to him through the year, who was inspirational to him, Magnum T.A. And finally, the most hated wrestler of the year, the NWA Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair.
Now let's take a look at pro wrestling this week's ratings. First of all, our parade of champions, the top 10 contenders in Wild West wrestling, and then our thumbs down feature.
Gordon, I only get to do this once a year. I've got to ask you this week now, who is the Wrestler of the Week?
Well, Bill, of course, the Wrestler of the Week this year, by unanimous decision of the Board of Directors, all of the recipients of Pro Wrestling Illustrated's Achievement Awards for 1987. And my particular congratulations to my good friend Paul Boesch out in Texas. I can assure you, I feel that each of these people certainly deserved the awards that they were awarded from you, the fans, through Pro Wrestling Illustrated. Bill, looking forward to your returning next year with more Achievement Awards.
Thank you very much. I want to thank everybody out there for being such great supporters of Pro Wrestling Illustrated and Pro Wrestling this week.
And until next week, when Joe Pedicino will return, this would be Gordon Solie saying join us again for Pro Wrestling This Week.